Yeah, that's fine. I can pick up food on the way back.
Matt!
Shane! What are you doing here?
Well, Bridget would have been upset if I had come to your house, so...
Man, I'm not complaining. I just figured you'd be in space or building a hover car or something. Golly, it's been like...
4 years, 3 months, 21 days.
Hey, Matt. The usual?
Yes, ma'am. This right here is my brother, Shane. Shane, this is Robin,
your favorite waitress at the downtown diner. I'll take an apple juice, lots of ice. Don't worry about the spill.
Black coffee, apple juice, plenty of ice.
Still sticking to apple juice, huh? You know, it's funny, every time I pack...
Katie's lunch, she always asks for a juice box. I guess she takes after her uncle. Me.
You have somehow gotten more awkward.
Go to ESPN, live stream. Liverpool versus Manchester United. Roberto Firmino will score off a corner.
Let me get there first. Now, what?
Roberto Firmino scores off a corner.
Alana down the right, inside.
Now.
Firmino scores off the corner, out of nowhere. Liverpool leads
United. I cannot believe the Mustang High Mathlete captain just told me to watch the sport.
Math got me a full ride to MIT. What did playing with a ball get you?
Laid.
Laid, sure.
One black coffee and it. Sorry.
No worries.
Oh, gosh.
I'm due for an upgrade anyway.
I will get you another apple juice.
No need.
So
sorry. How'd you know Firmino was gonna score that goal?
I'll show you. Let's go.
Well, let's wait till we get our breakfast first. I'm a much better listener when I have my bacon. What's that?
Timer. We need to leave right now. Pay the waitress. Left pocket.
Okay, guess I'll call in sick.
This afternoon, a fire breaks out in the forest by Pines Road.
Oh, where Dad and I used to force you to come camping
exactly.
With us.
Exactly. 18 people die. We have to get there and stop it before it starts.
Well, I'll put in a call. I'll get some trucks up there.
No, when we did that, they turn up and they leave because the fire hasn't happened yet.
Hey. Wait, so you're like a... time-traveling Smokey the Bear?
It's actually a time loop. I discovered that if I manipulate the cosmic string phases by 3.8 steps...
What?
I can repeat time. I don't have the energy yet to go any further back past today, and I have to reset the loop by sunset or I'm stuck in the present, but...
So it's kind of like Groundhog Day.
Yeah, kind
of. Are you coming?
Your battery's dead. I rented an SUV for us to use.
My battery is not dead. Well, I'm still driving.
Okay, take Jefferson out towards Margarita.
49 is way faster.
It's gonna be an accident. Loose tire. Take the next left, skip Kings. Water main broke, flooded the street.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir, you want your windows washed?
Oh, no, man, we're good. You're trying to get us killed?
I'll explain when we fix the flat.
What? Dude, what is going on?
In 0.25 miles, there'll be an underpass by the railroad track. Park next to the track.
Shane, man, you are freaking me out, dude. How did you know the tire was gonna blow? The battery was dead. Firmino scores that goal. What is going on?
So it happened before. Change the tire.
Right. Time loop. Okay. Okay. Why does it seem like the entire world is against us since we left that diner?
Because it is. Time is a scientist. We're just rats stuck in her maze. She doesn't want us to get to the exit, so she keeps adding more walls, more traps.
It's very progressive pronoun use.
Thank you. Look, 100 things will go wrong to make sure we don't get to this fire. I've relived this day again and again and again. And I still haven't been able to get to the fire with you.
So we've had this conversation before?
Oh, yeah.
All right, then what am I going to say next? Trick question. I'm not going to say anything. Thanks for the help.
Welcome.
Hey, you remember that time you helped me run for class president? You tried to hack the... school computer system and rigged the election for me?
Tried. You were elected 8th grade president, as I recall.
I was running for sixth grade president.
Really?
Dude, you don't remember that? He called us into Principal Bedford's office. He couldn't believe that you had memorized 400 lines of code and forgot your own brother's age.
We gotta go, finish that up.
I'm 28. Put on some music.
No. Let's keep the radio off.
Who needs music when you have random beeping?
I've calibrated it to go off at key moments to keep us on schedule. If we don't meet the deadlines, bad things happen.
What about the clicking? Is that part of the... What have you been up to the last 4 years, buddy?
When you're with me, we've never made it past the roadblock before.
Oh, me? Oh, well, you beat the police in the annual softball game. Katie had a bouncy castle at her birthday party, and that was a whole lot of fun. Dude, honestly, I got some big news. Bridget.
We're here. Pull over here. Pull over. Stop here.
You want me to gun it, see if we can break through this barricade?
No, when we did that, the car flips and you're decapitated.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I need to turn back. Sinkhole up here. Took out the whole damn road.
Okay, I'm gonna talk to him, see
no,
if we
you can't.
Well, what do you think we should do?
I'll try something new.
Did you hear what I said? The road's closed.
I saw the poster for your missing dog.
Say what?
I actually found him.
Jasper. My dog, is he okay?
Yeah, he's tied up in front of the downtown diner. I set up food and water, which should prevent discomfort until you retrieve him.
Okay. But how do you even... No way, it doesn't even matter, man. Thank you. Thank you so much. Hey, I need you to cover for me at Pines Road. Hey, you know how Jasper went missing today? Yeah, some guy found him.
Better take a lot of time lapse to find that dog.
Not really. I took him from his backyard this morning. Okay, we're on foot from here. Key's back.
All right. You ready to save the world? You want to time travel back? Try that again?
No. Let's go. Come on. Pick it up.
Pick it up.
We're here. This is it.
Hey, sorry about this. No fires today. Y'all shouldn't be out here by yourselves anyway. You have some weirdo come up to you. Well, you don't have to run up me or whatever.
We did it.
We did it!
I'm glad you're here.
You know, this isn't really a fire that would have gotten out of control, though. There's a good perimeter, and there's a lot of...
What's that?
It's my emergency pager. Five-alarm fire broke out downtown, 6 blocks from the diner. Why'd you bring me out here?
When you stay downtown, you die. We tried to stop the fire hundreds of times. We stopped the electrical fire, and then an oven fire breaks out in the kitchen. We stopped the kitchen fire, then 3 teenagers forget to put a cigarette out next door. Fire always happens. You always die. I always live. Even when you manage to rescue a few people, you never make it out. So, I started looking for another exit to the maze, away from the fire. I spent days searching for locations. I calibrated what would be the shortest safe distance away, and then it hit me. Here, so we used to go camping with Dad.
Firemen don't run from fires.
Something always happened. It brought you back to the fire or killed you on your way out of town. But this time, I saved you this time.
I don't need you to save me, Shane. Why do you even care? You've talked to me like twice since Dad died.
Yeah, but look, if I could create a time loop that goes back to when...
I don't care about time loops, Shane!
If you don't care, why did you come?
Because I wanted to spend time with my brother. Give me the keys, Shane.
No, I can't do that.
Give me the keys, Shane! People are dying!
No. Matt. You can't escape the maze.
How's it going? Work at the fire station 3 downtown.
If you're a firefighter, you need to get your asses back out in town, man. There's a fire out there, not back here.
I found your dog.
Throw on some music.
The fire downtown has spread to a second building. Firefighters are just arriving at the scene.
You gotta go back.
No radio.
Oh, no, 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 no.
We gotta go.
Nope.
Back at the station, like now. Fire downtown.
All right, I'm coming.
How about you give me all your fucking money?
There's going to be a fire downtown. We can stop it. You bring every fire truck you can get. Okay, it's just us, no fire trucks. You go in through the front. I'm going in through the front. Okay, look, I've timed this out. If we don't leave right now, you die. Don't go for the hose. What are you not gonna do?
Go for the hose.
Hurry now. How is it already? It should be working.
Find it out.
Yeah, that's fine. I can pick up food on the way back.
Matt.
Shane! What are you doing here?
Can't check up on my brother? Oh, wow.
I'm not complaining. I just figured you'd be in space or building a hover car or something. Golly, it's been like...
4 years, 3 months, 21 days.
Hey, Matt. The usual?
Yes, ma'am. This right here is my brother, Shane. Shane, this is Robin, the best waitress at the downtown diner.
Can I get you anything?
I will take an apple juice, extra ice.
Black coffee, apple juice, plenty of ice.
Still sticking to apple juice, huh? You know, it's funny, every time I pack Katie's lunch, she always asks for a juice box. I think she takes after her uncle a little bit.
Does she still eat Cocoa Puffs? Lucky Charms?
Better, actually. She eats chocolate Lucky Charms.
I didn't even know those existed.
Well, they do, and we have family-sized boxes by the dozen.
It's amazing.
What's that?
This is... Nothing. Hey, have you got time to stay for breakfast?
Fuck no, man. Need a ladder? Get some bigger fucking stones, man. Here then.
Oh, easy.
What are you doing, dickhead? No. He's on with this, mate. See, that's how you break a window. Then. Go on, keep crawling. So you're out this Friday?
What else to do? Tom would be going out, so he'll probably end up there. Where is he anyway? Tom? Don't know, he's not down there. Fucking hell! I nearly shit myself.
Go home now, I'm bored.
Said you would be. Next time I'll leave you on by yourself if you want.
it.
What are you doing?
Just a minute, be good this. Ready?
Go on, mate.
Ready?
Do it again.
See how long you can keep them off for?
No.
What are you scared like?
It's all right. Just tell me and I'll switch it back on.
Okay.
Freddie.
Where's Michael?
Very good. Where is he?
What? Don't look at me. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, let's go again.
Okay, my turn though. Now I'll stand together. Freddy, stand in the middle. Now hold each other's hands.
What?
Come on, my game now.
Well, you've got lovely soft hands.
Fuck off.
Ready? Where are they hiding?
Don't know.
Come on, Freddy! You'd have to be a dickhead like Tom.
Oi!
You're not catching me out. Stand behind Grace. Okay, this time a bit quicker. Ready? I'll be too quick for you this time! Isn't it? Don't lie! You shouldn't have fucking brought you here! Right, you two! You win! Ah, fucking ha! We'll come out now. Come out, then. Okay! If you don't come out now, I'm gonna lock you in here! Grace?
Yeah?
Can you hear them?
No, can you? Emily?
Thank you.
crazy party, huh?
Thanks.
Dave.
Ivy.
Right, yeah, the one who wants to start the
commune.
You don't treat it like a dirty word.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't have to be. I just want to live in the woods, surrounded by people I love. Maybe not all in a big hippie house, but, you know, we'd share vegetables, and someone roast coffee, and someone else...
Stills mezcal.
Yes. So what would you contribute? Beer, livestock, hand-knit couch and sweaters?
Yeah, like the harvest seaweed.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you could cultivate yourself a little underwater garden.
And collect it in my hand-carved dinghy.
Yeah, your dinghy?
Yeah.
Oh, and you could hang the seaweed up to dry in your wood shop so that all the furniture you build always carries with it the scent of the sea.
Do you want to hang out sometime?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Great, can I grab your...
But wait, like, hang out or go out?
They're the same?
Well, hanging out implies that you might call me dude or that your bros could show up with Jaeger bombs at any moment.
My bros, and dude is really more of a gender neutral...
I'm sorry. I've just dated a lot of shitty... I just want to make sure we're on the same page.
Same page.
Oh, God, no. No. This has gone sideways so quickly.
I don't think I'm looking for anything.
I'm not trying to put a ring on it, Dave. I'm just asking if... Shit. We were hitting it off, right?
I don't know. These things take time.
These things? But we... Seaweed furniture. Okay.
I gotta get back. Okay.
What, to the party? Yeah, sounds about right. What the actual fuck?
Hey! It's crazy in there.
Thanks, Dave.
You're welcome,
Ivy.
Right, yeah, the one who wants to start the commune. But like a modern one with technology and no polyamory.
I mean, people can love whoever they want. One partner's complicated enough for me.
Are you okay? That indica they were passing around in there is pretty strong. I can call you a cab.
No. I'm just having the weirdest deja vu right now.
Really? So have we entered an alternate universe? You know, like glitch theory. It says that deja vu is like this clue that something has changed. We're now living in a different universe. Like how Berenstein Bears has apparently always been spelled with an A. No? Okay, that's totally crazy. It's probably just a malfunction between the short-term and long-term circuits.
Strong indica, huh?
So, tell me more about your commune. I've always had a weird obsession with harvesting.
Seaweed.
Yeah, yes! How did you know?
It's typical for dream men like you.
What?
It's a typical dream for men like you.
Do you want to hang out sometime?
No. Yes. No, no, no. Maybe. No, no, thank you.
Oh, you got a boyfriend?
No.
Girlfriend?
No. You see, the thing is, Dave, I'm looking for something meaningful right now.
Me too.
Really?
We all want someone to connect with, right?
What? But, like, you want a relationship?
Well, I mean, these things...
Take time?
Exactly, but I want that with someone meeting. You know, someone to go on adventures and share seaweed with.
Okay. Yeah, sure. I mean, maybe we could go on a...
Hey! It is
crazy in there. Ivy, right? Yeah, Dave. God, you're amazing.
Whoa, too far.
Wait up!
Okay. Hi.
Dave, hi. We didn't really get a chance to talk about your comic.
And of course, I collected in my hand-carved dinghy.
Your dinghy?
Yeah.
And you could hang the seaweed up to dry in your wood shop, so the furniture you build always carries with it the scent of the sea.
Do you want to?
I'd love to.
What?
Go out sometime.
Sure.
Well, that's what you were gonna ask, right?
Yeah, yes, if you want.
No.
Wait, what? But you...
No, you're clearly emotionally stunted, therefore completely unavailable without massive game playing, and I don't have the energy right now.
Hey, I am not emotionally... Why not?
I'm clearly emotionally stunted, therefore completely unavailable right now.
Really?
No!
Why not? I thought we had a connection. I mean, seaweed furniture.
Why not? Because I'll fall in love with you. That's why not. Because it's what I do. Because you'll be super great at first, and we'll share all these interests and hopes and dreams, and I'll get attached, and I'll start calling you more. Except by calling, I mean texting and liking your Instagram photos, and God forbid what will happen if we're Facebook friends. And you'll notice, of course, at least subconsciously, and that's when you'll start pulling away. Which obviously will only make me increasingly more neurotic until the inevitable breaking point that I demand to talk about the state of our relationship that I'm desperately clinging onto and you're backing away from that no one even really wants anymore. And you'll say you can't commit because of your job or your last girlfriend or your fucking ficus, and I'll be forced to walk away. Which is sad, of course, because I won't get laid, but I also won't waste my time or lose any more pieces of my heart. You know, those little ones that chip away with every hopeful date, because you're never gonna love me back. Because you've already put me in the needy box, that little box for women who love too much, too fast, too soon, and there's never any coming back from that. So I'm just gonna walk away now.
The ficus is oddly specific.
That's your takeaway from this?
No, of course not. Hey. Wait up.
You're not actually following me right now, are you? Oh, I've given your brain something to hunt. You're just like the rest of them. No, no grasses.
Hey, I'm not just like, come on, Ivy, that's not, I've had a shitty time dating too. Girls, women aren't always who they say they are, and you think you're dating one person, then all of a sudden.
I'm sorry, we all suck. So let's just not even bother.
What, I don't get to rant after all that.
Rant away, I'm gonna. This thing is supposed to.
You are high, aren't you? One date.
So what happens after this date?
You go on another one.
Yeah.
And then another one?
Mm-hmm.
And then you demand we talk about the state of our relationship?
And are you gonna be an adult about it?
Depends on those dates, I guess.
We women get the bad rap, but it's you guys who want fireworks and sweeping feelings instead of just putting in the work.
Hey, you gotta build to the sweeping feelings. Women always want to jump in right away.
No, not true. Dudes ramp up right off the bat all the time, and as soon as we follow suit, you freak out.
Even if things feel natural at the beginning, that can change, and it takes time to know for sure.
How long?
Well, it's not a quota, Ivy. It's too much pressure. We just want a slow build, time to figure out
what you're feeling.
Yeah.
You know what, Dave? Did you ever think you don't need time? That love could be a choice?
So what, all those shitty guys you did, if falling in love was a choice?
Yeah, it was. I didn't know it then. But these feelings aren't magic. They come from somewhere. Anyway, now that I know that, I'm not gonna waste my time with some dude who's incapable of talking about a theoretical future. Because I know this conversation seems urgent and alarming to you, but for me, it's just laying the groundwork to see if you're emotionally evolved enough to say yes. I do want a relationship. If we keep hitting it off and if we keep inspiring and driving each other a little bit crazy, then yes, that's what I want. That's where we'll end up. It's not a promise. And it's not a guarantee. It's just the simple knowledge that we're on the same page, in the same place in our lives.
I guess that's fair.
Thanks for your validation, Dave.
What's happening?
You still want to go on that date?
I do, actually.
All right. Fuck it. I'm in.
When? Where?
Parallel universe, baby.
Campbell here. Appreciate all of you tuning in on this beautiful Michigan summer night. We've got some more relaxing...
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.